Usually when we think of improving in Fortnite, we picture hours on hours of grinding every day to perfect our craft, right? And so this can be very demotivating, especially if you haven't, you know, felt any better within your recent sessions. But what if I told you that there's things that you can do to instantly feel improvement in your gameplay? Bunch of crunch on me, where you at, your motivation guy? Yes, sir, I am back. Today, I'm talking about, all right, something really cool. We're going to be going over several different ways that you can instantly improve your mechanics and game sense. And so some of these tricks can be done every day for more and more improvement, while others can take just a few seconds to really complete. You guys ready for this? Yo, let's get this going. All right, guys. So the first way that you can instantly improve your mechanics is by using the right in-game settings. And so this is very important in Fortnite as it can really decide how well you play. And so chances are that many of you already use pretty good settings, but you know, we're quickly going to go over it for those of you who don't. So one of the most important settings to have right is your sensitivity. So this is mostly preference, but if you have it extremely high or extremely low, chances are you're holding yourself back. Now, explaining this would take very long, and most of you probably already have a pretty good sensitivity, but if you're not so sure, I recommend watching our most recent videos on it to really find out if your sensitivity is really allowing you guys to really play to your maximum potential. And so another way that you can improve your mechanics is by using the right graphic settings. And so if you're on PC, you're going to want to make sure to put all your graphics quality settings on low, as well as use performance mode, since it will lower your input delay and boost your FPS a significant amount. So performance mode will also add a new setting to your graphics quality called meshes. Feel free to use whichever option you prefer for this one. A low meshes setting will give you better performance, but it will make your builds look low quality and really hard to see through. Also, you can leave your 3D resolution at 100%, but lowering it to 80% range will increase your game's performance by a noticeable amount. And so if you don't want to do that, you can just try 1600 by 900 for your resolution, and that will give you guys a similar performance impact. You should also turn off your VSync and, you know, motion blur settings, since VSync will give you input delay and motion blur will make it just hard to see while moving your screen around quickly. One more optional setting we recommend trying out for better performance is to really set your frame rate limit one setting higher than your monitor's refresh rate. So doing this will make your game run smoother by keeping your FPS above your monitor's range during small FPS drops, as well as lowering your input delay by a small amount. And so this next tip, guys, is one that you could do every day as a quick warm-up, and it'll definitely improve your speed of edits every time you complete it. All right, so we're talking about challenging edit courses. This will only take a couple minutes, man, depending on the edit course, but you have to make sure it's challenging. So you're doing an edit course that you're comfortable with, or you know that you've done multiple times before, you most likely won't find any improvement since it's gonna be based on muscle memory instead of how fast you can really make random edits. Think about it when you're in-game, right? And you come across a player that's extremely fast. You're probably gonna be building and editing without much time to really think about it. And when you're just up against a player like this, every single edit matters. So the slower you edit, you know, and the more edits you miss, the higher your chances are of losing the fight. And so this is why, guys, it's just very important to really use new and challenging edit courses that aren't just easy to run through. And I guarantee you this, man, that, you know, once you finish a challenging edit course, you'll instantly notice the improvement in your speed. So test it out yourself and just see how you feel while free building afterwards. Oh, definitely make sure that you're not using the edit course for too long at a time. It can make your hands fatigued and possibly slow you down if you're really not used to it. So I recommend starting with around 5 minutes and then just doing more if your hands feel fine. All right, so now that we've talked to, you know, about a couple of ways to improve your mechanics, let's talk about game sense, all right? For the most part, improving your game sense is a long process that really, you know, just takes hard work and patience. But, you know, there are countless amount of game sense related scenarios that you can improve on in seconds with VOD reviewing. All right, you could use it to your advantage in scrims, tournaments, arena, and anything that you want to, really. Of course, going over tournaments can take a good amount of time, but, you know, there's more than just one way to VOD review. All right, so let's just say that you are eliminated in arena and have no idea what you did wrong. Well, you can quickly go into the replay system and just watch back the fight to see what your opponent did and how you could have countered it to win the fight. And it doesn't really take much time, guys. And afterwards, you're gonna know exactly what to do the next time you're in a similar situation. So if you don't already, try this out next time, you know, you're wondering why you're eliminated, right? And really, just like our last tip, the more you do this, the more you're gonna get better. All right, so VOD reviewing your games can be a challenging thing to do. I mean, like, how do you even know what you're meant to be looking for if you didn't know what you should have did the first time? Well, you know, if you want the edge in your opponents, ProGuys.com has the answer for you guys. Our innovative VOD review system will allow you to upload your replays, and then our team of pro coaches will go over everything you did wrong and everything you did right so you can get tailor-made feedback and advice. I mean, it's really the best way to improve fast. All right, guys, so another way that you can instantly improve your mechanics is by making your edits as safe as possible at all times. And so this is something a lot of players struggle with, and it's not always easy to remember. You know, even pros make dangerous edits here and there, but if you always have this in the, you know, the back of your mind while fighting, it'll definitely improve your gameplay as soon as you really start thinking about it. You know, a couple of examples of this would be, you know, things like making a window edit after boxing an opponent and just right-hand peeking them. Using top right edits for quick wall peeks instead of your tile edits. And, you know, even using triple edits for counter piece control while ramping directly at an opponent. There's just a huge amount of different ways to really make your edits as safe as possible, you know? So make sure to really get that habit, you know, instead of just making unnecessary wide edits that can really just get you eliminated super fast. So remember, guys, it's better to take your time with safe edits than to make lightning fast edits that expose your player model. So a great way to make your mechanics faster and more consistent is really to build fight players who are better than you. Of course, build fighting a player with the same skill level helps, but build fighting a player that's better than you, yo, that means that you have to minimize the amount of mistakes that you make and really raise your speed of mechanics. And so this is also very useful for piece control practice because you're gonna need it here more than in your usual fights. You know, even just a couple of rounds of just putting your full effort into this as a warm-up will show you like noticeable improvement as soon as you're finished. And so you can mix this up and just try it, you know, in zone wars and box fights as well, you know? And if you don't have any friends who are better than you, feel free to find another player from an open scrim Discord server. Also, you know, don't feel bad about your skill level if you're losing every round, right? Just try as hard as you can and just really remind yourself that this is making you a better player at an extremely fast rate, all right? Now, this tip is one that may win you a lot more fights, and that's crosshair placement. It is extremely important in Fortnite as it affects your speed and accuracy for building, right? It also helps you with editing, aim, and so on. And so there are multiple ways you can instantly improve your crosshair placement, such as, you know, keeping your crosshair at, you know, headshot level before peeking an opponent. And this will definitely raise your chances of hitting big pumps while running around corners or peeking through windows, as well as, you know, other types of aim. And so another great way to really take advantage of your crosshair placement, guys, is by finding your opponent's head through the cracks of your build. And, you know, being ready to really line up your crosshair for it, you know, after making a smart edit. So good crosshair placement also helps with building and editing by allowing you to set up your crosshair for an edit, you know, you're about to make while building quickly. And this will make your edits easier and faster since you're gonna be eliminating the need to really flick to them. All right, so you should play around with this in your next session, man, and you're gonna find all the different ways you can take advantage of good crosshair placement to really push your gameplay to the next level. All right, bunch of crunch time, it's time for the question of the day. I hope you're still here. What mechanics do you have, you know, the hardest time within Fortnite? You know, is Bloom really getting you down, or are you just getting outbuilt in every fight that you try to get into? All right, be honest. Look, there's no judgment, no shame. We're all getting better each and every day. Let us know in the comments and we'll check it out. All right, so the last tip that'll definitely help your game sense during fights if you often make this simple mistake, because we notice a lot of players do, you know, do this after, you know, improving their mechanical skill. We're gonna be talking about making sure you're not putting too much focus towards your mechanics while fighting. Of course, mechanics require focus, right? But they should come second nature. You should be practicing your mechanics enough and creative so that you could focus on the more important things during fights, such as your opponent's actions and really just thinking of what kind of plays you can make on them. And so it's just really good to practice new builds and edits that you recently learned in order to really get them into your muscle memory. But, you know, if you're in the middle of a fight against a good player and you're too busy worrying about something such as your edit speed, your opponent is most likely gonna make a good play on you and take you out, like something that you didn't even see coming. While if you were paying attention to your opponent and allowing your mechanics to come second nature, you could have countered that play or completely eliminated their opportunity to make it in the first place. And instead of that, you know, the thought of a smart play of your own to really make on them. Now, I'm not saying ignore the fact that you need good mechanics while fighting, but what I am saying is really meet in the middle and allow your muscle memory to take control of the building, editing, aiming, and movement as you make the smart plays so that your brain now has room to make more. All right, Budget Crush Tommy, we're going to do a quick recap. Using the right settings will increase your system performance as well as your mechanical speed. You know, running through challenging edit courses will make your edits faster and more consistent. Quick VOD reviews can improve your game sense more than you think. You know, smart edits will help you avoid heavy hits from your opponents. And so build fighting players better than you, that's going to increase your overall mechanical skill in just a couple rounds. So taking advantage of good crosshair placement will increase consistency in your aim and editing. And lastly, making sure that you're focusing on good players during fights more than you're focusing on your mechanical skill. All right, Butcher Chris Army, you know, Fortnite is one of the most mechanically intensive competitive games out there at the moment, and mastering all the mechanics that you need to succeed can be quite a daunting prospect, right? So just remember, guys, to never give up, never surrender, man. Keep on grinding. You mean, you're going to get there. I'm telling you, you're going to get there in the end. And if you want to watch more incredible tips and tricks videos, you should definitely check out the rest of our channel for even more. If you guys liked the video, like it, subscribe to the channel. And if you want some more motivation, I'm right here, man. Connect to me on my Instagram at Your Motivation Guy. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.